A very, very, very good afternoon to everyone. Denzel Moles Unscripted, as always, I can be found on Facebook as Denzel Moles Unscripted. I can also be found on YouTube as Denzel Moles Official. Today I decided to do the video out in the park. It's such a beautiful day, and I really appreciate the day. I appreciate the weather. It's been favorable for us, so that's why I decided that I should, you know, for I should at least for once drop out a video up there. Just go out in the nature, sit in the nature, embrace the nature, and, you know, pick up on the sunlight, and, you know, just talk to my fans and my friends around the world. So, as I said, Denzel Moles Unscripted on YouTube. I can be found as Denzel Moles Official. For those of you who are following me on YouTube, it's quite a small number, but I really appreciate, and I'm really very grateful for that. I really appreciate all of you, and I really encourage you, if you've seen my videos and if you keep on following me, you can always subscribe. If you haven't done so, you can always like the page, you can always share with the friends, and let the message get out there. So before I dive deep into the subject, I want to make something very clear. Denzel Moles Unscripted is a page whereby we do not sit on the truth. So we say out the truth the way it is. So I speak out the truth. I'm out to speak for the empaths, and my vision for the beginning of this year, actually even towards the end of last year, I made it very clear that this year I'm going to set empaths free. Empaths, I've told you, those are the people in some sort of vulnerable situations, especially in relationships, and people who can't get out, and people who think that they're just, you know, trapped, and they don't know what to do with themselves, and sometimes they don't know what is going on with them. And I've been talking about a lot of things, and a lot of people have gotten back to me, and a lot of people have been able to contact me, and we have already shared one or two things, and I've been able to advise them accordingly. So I must also want to talk about the issue of some people who are watching my page. There are some people who are in the categories of abusers. There are some people who are abusers, and then there's the abusers, and then they are the abused. So there are two categories of people. So when I'm talking about anything on my page, is strictly concerning people who are in the abusive situation, who are being abused. So I may drop out some material, and it might have to slap somebody in the face. So I mean, this is not personal. The material may slap somebody in the face, and they may not like the truth, because some of the people who are actually in these abusive situations don't even know that they are being abused. So I'm here to give light, and, you know, to enlighten people about this whole thing of abuse. And
Hi,
you alright?
Yeah.
Okay, bye. I'm busy. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, so you know what I mean. Sorry about that. You know, it's just because I'm in the park, like I've told you. So there may be one or two things going around. The kids, I mean, there are people working with dogs, so I may get interrupted for every now and then. But that won't stop me from, you know, from carrying on. So in case I say something and it resonates with somebody out there, I have about 5,000 people on my Facebook. So there, of course, different categories of people around the world, they're watching my videos, and it might be in one case or the other, there may be somebody who is in the abuse category. So they are the ones who are actually abusing someone. So they may find this material offensive to them, but I just want to make it clear that this is not personal. You know what I mean? My page is strictly truth, and my page is strictly setting empaths free. I've made that vision very clear from the beginning of this year, and actually somewhere towards the end of last year, I've made it very clear that I'm going to set empaths free. And how do I do that? Is by giving light in their situations and letting them and opening their eyes so that they can actually know whether they are being abused or not. The decision what to do next is going to be, it has nothing to do with me, but only thing I'm just trying to do is to open their eyes and, you know, to enlighten them about some situations that they may actually not have been able to understand. Now, I would not like to take this thing very long. I want to dig deep into today's subject, which is going to be something what they call flying monkeys. And before that, I talk about flying monkeys, I'm going to talk about a very, very common trait of abusers. Abusers, when you're with these kind of people, when you're with these individuals, you're going to find yourself, like, sometimes they are doing something what they call the reverse psychology, you know? So they are manipulating you in a psychological way, and they are making things which actually, they are making things look like the opposite from what they actually are. So I can give you an example of reverse psychology. Sometimes, you know, women, they like to look nice. You know, women like to look nice. Or even men sometimes, but I mean, women like to do a lot of all these makeups. And they want to know, they want to get up in the morning and put on their best dress, you know, put on their best makeup, you know, put on their best shoes, you know, for whichever occasion they are going to, whether they are going to work, or sometimes they are going for a party, or sometimes they are going for a wedding. So sometimes you are going to find something, there's a manipulative game these people use. Sometimes you will get up in the morning, you know, go in the bathroom, put on your makeup, you know, pick out your best dress, put on your best dress, you know, and then you're going to come in front of them. And you're going to ask for their opinion. I mean, honey, how do I look? What do you think about my outfit? What do you think about this? So these people, I've told you guys, these people, they have got a very, very rare disorder called NPD, and they cannot judge correctly. They cannot judge things correctly. This is not personal. This is just something to do with the disorder. So they're just going to tell them that, you know what, you look like shit, for example, you know? You look like shit. Why are you putting on this kind of dress? You know what I mean? But in the actual sense, you know, in your heart of hearts, and you know deeply in your inner self, that you know that you're looking okay and everything with you is okay. You have got the best dress, you've got a suitable dress. So they are just, you're just going to come to them and ask for their opinion, you know? What do you think, honey, about this? How do you think? How do I look? You know, will I be presentable enough for the party or not? So they are going to overturn this situation for you to think. So that's what I call psychological manipulation, because they are going to make you believe that actually you're not looking good. You know what I mean? You don't look good in your clothes, you don't look good with your makeup, and they don't like your hairstyle, they don't like your shoes. But the actual sense is that there is actually nothing wrong with you. Everything is okay with you. You know what I mean? So there's nothing wrong with you. You've done your best. You're trying, because remember, these people, because they are not satisfied, they're always seeking for more and more and more, something what they call supply. They want to see people who are miserable. They want to make you they want to make you angry all the time. They want to fight with you. They want to always make you scream, because this is some kind of supply. It's called a positive supply. So sometimes they get positive supply, and sometimes they can get, you know, something what they can call a negative kind of supply. So they are not going to resonate with you in each and everything you do. You are going to cook for them the best meal. You are going to spend hours in the kitchen preparing your best meals. You are going to put it on the table, and they are going to come out and they are going to tell you that this meal is not worth it. You know, the food is halfway cooked, or the meat is halfway cooked, or the food is overburnt, or this and that. So each and everything you are going to try to do to make things look like you're having a smooth relationship, it is going to turn out to be very bad, and it's going to always turn against you. So this is how the disorder works, you know what I mean? It has nothing, it's not personal, but it's something to do with somebody's programming in the mind, the way they are able to assess situations and to understand some circumstances. So you're going to do a lot of things at home. You're going to do each and everything to make sure that you please your partners, you please your boyfriend or husband or your girlfriend or wife. So you're going to do each and everything in your power to make sure that you've got a happy relationship, you want to please them, but every time you're coming to them and asking for their opinions, they are always going to put you down. They are going to actually complain you're cooking the worst food. They are going to complain you're always arriving late at work, at home. Sometimes even you are maybe 1 or 2 or 3 minutes late. But still, when you come in the house, they are still going to complain for the 2 or 3 minutes. They do not have any feeling whatsoever that there are sometimes cases whereby things can go wrong. So they don't accept that. They just want to see you all the time struggling to please them. You are always struggling to please somebody. But guys, remember that this is a disorder, and anybody you ever feel that you're actually every day on a daily basis, you're trying to impress somebody, and people, they're actually not getting impressed. Even if in your higher self, in your inner self, you know that actually the things you're doing, they are the right things. You are cooking the best food for them. You're always getting up and washing their cars. You're making the bed. You're cleaning their house. You know, you're taking care of the kids. You're doing each and everything at home. And then they are still not appreciating you. You have got to have something in the back of your head that is actually going to confirm to you that you're not dealing with somebody with a healthy mind. You know what I mean? So it's not personal. I've just wanted to give you an example of that kind of reverse psychology, whereby these people, because they are manipulators, they always try to overturn these situations to look like, you know, you there's something wrong with you, everything is wrong with you, you're doing things the wrong way. So there is nothing you ever do with an abuser that is going to be perfect. Each and everything you are going to do, and each and every endeavor you are going to fight to impress or to impress somebody, is always going to turn out against you. So that is the way that this word as well works. Now, there are so many things I can talk about in that kind of reverse psychology. There are so many things that happen in the homes. And for example, you can say, you can talk about something positive. So when you talk about something positive with them, they are going to overturn that thing and it's going to look negative. So they're always negative people because they don't have emotions. They don't have genuine emotions. They have got the fake emotion, like I've told you guys before. These guys have got an invisible mask. So they've got a mask that they're using on their face just to fool to the whole world that, you know, what they look, how they're looking, or however they appear to the outside world is what they are actually inside. But this is just an invisible mask just to try to shadow their inner self. So they don't want their inner self to show up to the public. So whenever they come out to the public, they try to paint a different picture. They try to tell people that everything is good at home. You guys are perfect. You're doing well. Everything is nice. But when actually you come out, you come back home together, you get back in the house, the whole drama starts over again. So if you ever see yourself in the kind of situation whereby somebody is abusing you every day, and then when they are coming out in the public to your friends, they are showing them a different picture that, you know, you guys are very happy, everything is nice, you know, they have the best wives, they are the best girlfriend, they are the best boyfriends, and then when they come back to home, they start to abuse you, you have got to know that this is a cycle. That thing keeps on going on and on. It's like a cycle. So they just keep on going in circles. They leave a point, they go around and come back to that same point. So that thing is like a cycle. It's going to keep on and on and on and on and on. And sometimes, like I told you in the very first video, these are the kind of cycles that cause what they call a trauma bond. So you get trauma bonded and your ties, your souls are tied to each other in a very evil way. You know what I mean? So it's not a healthy way. It's a, I can call it a very unhealthy way. So your souls are tied together with your abuser, whereby you cannot get out. The person is abusing you every day, and the person is... A person is abusing you and is manipulating you every day, and then love bombing you at the same time. So this kind of thing is causing some kind of a toxic situation whereby you start to get confused whether somebody is actually abusing you or whether somebody loves you. So you get that kind of a cocktail which manipulates your brain to think you are in love. But the only thing you are, actually, you are just in love with your abuser. You know what I mean? So these are kind of cycles that keep on going on and on and on and on. You will see them every day. You will see them until you reach a point whereby you're going to get addicted to this kind of situation. And sometimes when you get addiction to something, is like, you know, when you're smoking, those guys who smoke weed, I don't smoke weed personally, but those guys who smoke pots and all that, they start to get that kind of addiction. So they cannot let go. You know, it's like any addiction, whether it's weed, whether it's alcohol, whether it's drugs, whether it's what, it can be anything, you know what I mean? So you get that kind of, like, you know, addiction whereby you cannot get rid of somebody because you are addicted to your abuser and you don't even know how to get out, you know what I mean? So now I will not spend a lot of time on that issue. I'm going to jump straight away to the issue what they call the flying monkeys. Now, flying monkeys is a trait whereby these people, they have got a very strange and a very weird, strange manipulative game, what they call psychologically, there's something what they call the flying monkeys. Now, this flying monkeys, one may want to wonder exactly what a flying monkey is. Now, these people, remember, guys, these people, they are very possessive and they are very obsessive in a very negative way and a very unhealthy way. So they are very possessive and they are very controlling. So usually what they do, sometimes you might find yourself walking and then you feel like somebody's over your shoulders. You're just looking back and you feel like somebody's following you. You know what I mean? So indeed, there's somebody following you, because these people, like I told you, they have got a certain type of energy, and that energy usually is a very evil energy. You know what I mean? So they always want to spy on each and everything you do. When you go out to the markets, they sometimes send people. There are some people what they call flying monkeys. So sometimes they send people to come and spy on you, you know, try to follow her exactly, or try to follow him and see what he's going to do, see who he's talking with. And sometimes there will be some of them, those people in their circles, they will be sending behind your back. And sometimes when you're walking in the street, sometimes you look over your shoulders, because this thing is energy. Everything is energy. Guys, I've always told you everything is energy. You just look over your shoulders and you'll have that gut instinct inside you that actually somebody's following you. You know what I mean? All I want to say is that indeed somebody's following you. And those people who do those kind of jobs, they are called flying monkeys. Sometimes they have flying monkeys on social media. These flying monkeys don't have to be physical. They can be somewhere everywhere, like on social medias. Sometimes they will send people, and people will open up fake profiles. So they will open up fake profiles and they will start to follow you. You know what I mean? Because they know that sometimes if they follow you and write to you directly, they will be directly involved in this situation. So what they do, they create sometimes even they can do it themselves. They create some kind of a fake profile just to monitor what you're doing on social media. Which are your friends? What posts are you liking on the pages? Who are you liking? Why did you add that friend? So they will see each and every person you talk to. They will see anybody you're messaging. They will see everybody who is commenting on your pages. They will see each and every photo you're liking. You know what I mean? So that is a technique, what they call flying monkeys. So they have that possessive and obsessive behavior, whereby they just like to keep on, like, you know, spying on you, and, you know, just to make you feel like you're always being watched. You know, like, you know what I mean? Have you ever got up in the morning whereby you just like you didn't know exactly whether you're being followed or you're being watched. You have got that instinct, you know, there's a gut instinct inside you that makes you believe that actually you're being followed. You know what I mean? You're always looking around your shoulders and you feel like somebody's following you. You know what I mean? So that is a gut instinct always trying to tell you, is your inner self, your higher self trying to tell you that actually there's somebody following you. And most of the cases, because you've got an abusive husband or boyfriend or wife at home, those people, they're very insecure. Actually, I can call it insecurity. So they are very insecure with themselves and they are not very sure that you can stay with them for a long period of time because they know that they are very abusive. So they don't trust themselves as well. So because they don't do that, it is that thing that actually activates them to start following you every day. They start following you, what you do, where you're going. Sometimes they will have people even following the car. If you're driving, sometimes you will see some other people following you behind. They want to see where you are going. What time did you enter the workplace? What time did you leave the workplace? Who did you go to the shops with? There was a guy you were speaking with. What did you tell him? So all those people, they are kind of people. They are called flying monkeys because those are the people who they are like propagandists. So those people, they always come back to these guys and they give them the information. And that is always where the fight starts because you're always going to come back at home and they are straight away going to slap it in your face. Yesterday, where did you go? I saw you entering this shop. What did you do? Who were you talking with? Then sometimes you will see them following your social medias, your Twitter accounts, your Instagram accounts, your Facebook accounts. You will see them opening up fake profiles. So they are going to open up fake profiles. A person can have like 5 or even 10 profiles, fake profiles. So sometimes when you realize that somebody is following on a certain profile, you block them, then they'll open up a new one. You'll also find out that one, then you block it, then you open a new one. So sometimes you find them that they have almost, I can say like, they have about 5, sometimes 4, sometimes 6. They have a lot of fake profiles on Facebook or on Instagram and all those social media platforms. And the only thing they are doing, because they are very insecure people, they are following you and they are following each and everything you're doing. Which posts are you liking on Facebook? How many friends do you have? Yesterday, you might have got 2 new friends on Facebook, or people might have added you or whatever. So they are going to monitor each and everything you're doing. And when you come back home, anytime they come back at home, that is where the fight is going to begin. Now, guys, I want you to be very, very, very careful with this kind of situation. It is a very abusive situation and it's a manipulative technique. Because remember, whenever they follow you using those kind of so-called propagandists, the flying monkeys, they're always going to feed them with information that I've seen your girlfriend here, I've seen your boyfriend there, I've seen them there, I've seen them there. So they are going to follow you up and then they're going to feed those abusers with information and you come back at home. So when you come back at home, that is where the fight is going to begin because they're going to start asking you all these kind of questions. Where were you? What were you doing? Who were you talking with on Facebook? I saw you in this market. Who was that guy next to you? What did he ask you? So you're going to find yourself in a very long loop of, what do they call it? They call it like... it's like a long loop of questions and answers. He's asking a question, you're answering. They're asking a question, you're answering. They're asking a question, you're answering. Guys, these people, they are called energy vampires. They are energy vampires because of a reason. The only thing they want to do is to suck out your energy in whichever way they can do. So they do that in a way of manipulation. That's why they call them psychological manipulators. Because every day, they want to fight with you and abuse you and intoxicate you with all those kind of things, those behaviors. And then at the end of the day, sometimes I know a lot of people, sometimes they have left those relationships and they have just ended up in therapy, you know. They just have to go to therapy because they have been abused for very long periods of time. And sometimes even they don't know they have been abused. You know what I mean? So that is the subject for today. What I wanted to talk about, flying monkeys or what they can call propagandists. And I've also talked about that that situation whereby there's that thing of the reverse psychology. You know what I mean? Whereby you keep on doing positive things at home, cooking for them nice food, you know, and then you come, they will come in and, you know, they maybe eat one or two spoons and they'll just send off the food to the bin and they'll say that your food is tasting like shit. You know what I mean? But remember, you've been spending hours in the kitchen. Sometimes you clean the house, you do each and everything for them. But when they come back, because these people, they never appreciate each and everything you do, they will always come back and find a reason to fight with you. You know what I mean? So that is some kind of reverse psychology whereby they want you to think that everything you're doing is in the reverse. You know what I mean? So whether you've been doing something good is bad. You know what I mean? So any good act or any good deed you do with them or you do to them, even sometimes they can sleep with you and they will tell you that, you know, I don't like the sex with you, you know, but you know whatever, you know what I mean? You've been giving them sometimes the best sex, but they're still going to complain that you're not giving them good sex. So each and everything you're doing, they do not appreciate because, guys, I've told you, this is a programming. These people, they are programmed in that way whereby that disorder doesn't allow them to reason and to think correctly. You know what I mean? Sometimes you will find them going around your friend's circles and saying some things about you. You know what I mean? But this one, I'm going to come to that subject later on when we reach the discard, because I'm going to... The next phase, I'm going to talk about the triangulation, the love triangles, how those guys do those love triangles and how they manipulate people using different partners. And then after the love triangle, I'm going to talk about something what they call the discard, the final discard. Then after the discard, I'm going to talk about the discard, then I'm going to talk about the smear campaign. So there's a lot of abusive traits going on out there. And I think that the more we give this light, the more we give this issue light, is the more people are going to set free. You know what I mean? People are going to be set free from toxic situations. You know what I mean? So, guys, I want to make it very clear that there's toxic people out there and there's toxic guys out there. The only thing you need to do, you need to just know the red flags. You need to read the signs. You need to read between the lines. Because most of these people, like I've been seeing some of them following me on YouTube and Facebook. Sometimes they know that they're abusive. So sometimes when you come out to speak against them, they try to make it look like you don't know what you're doing. You know what I mean? So you don't know what you're doing, or you don't know what you're saying, or something like that. So sometimes they try to make it look like, what you're doing is not worth it. Why are you even doing it in the first place? So they will try to do all those sorts of maneuver, because sometimes most of them, they are watching all these Facebook media platforms and they know the things they are doing. So they don't want the information to get out there because it's going to open people's eyes. But this year I've dedicated myself to set people free. So each and everybody who is in an abusive situation, everybody is meant to be happy. So each and everyone who is in an abusive situation for very long periods of time, year after year, and they're following my page, I know they are going to resonate with some of the things I'm saying, and at the end of the day, they're going to be set free. So guys, this has been a very very nice video. I just decided to do this video out in the nature because it's such a beautiful day, and I thought that I should, just give it a try, get out in the nature there, just drop one or two points. But anyhow, it's been a pleasure to have you all on board, and whoever's watching me, you're really appreciated. I really appreciate your time, and if you hear something with what I'm saying, and if it resonates with you, or if it resonates with a friend of yours somewhere out there, anybody in your circle, who may it be, in this kind of situations, you can always refer to my videos, and you can make your final decision. It's not my job to make the decision for you. My job is to get you the information, and my job is to give you to give enlightenment to this kind of abusive situations. So whatever final decision you have got to make, that is got to be your job. It's not going to be my job, because I cannot be out there enlightening people and then getting them out of toxic situations. So whatever decision each and everybody is going to make, that is going to depend on them. It's going to be their personal decision. So anyhow, guys, it's been a very beautiful day. It's a very beautiful afternoon. And you all, thank you very much. If you have not subscribed to my page, you can like my page. You can share the share the material. Let the information get out there. And if you have not liked me on YouTube, I've told you that I can be found by the names of Denzel Moore's Official. So you can just go on YouTube, like the page, subscribe. I'll always be dropping materials each and every now and then. And let's get the message out there and let's get people free. So guys, thank you very much. It's been a really beautiful day, and it's been a very big blessing. And I'm really, really, really humbled to have you online. Thank you very much. And a very blessing and a very good day to you all. A big blessing and a very good day to you all. Stay blessed, all of you. Thank you. Bye.